80% of all major world cities are situated in a coastal or delta zone. These areas offer little space for living, working, recreation, or infrastructure. At the same time, there is a growing need to maintain and, if possible, expand environmental, nature, and landscape values. All in all, this means that space is in ever greater demand. Another fundamental aspect is safety. The globe is in the grip of climatological changes that lead to flooding. We need measures that guarantee the safety of communities living in delta and coastal zones. The greatest challenge of this century is to develop and implement solutions that not only optimize the available space, but also boost the economy, guarantee safety, and improve the living environment. The solutions to these challenges can be found close to home. Over 35 years ago, Ronald Waterman successfully formulated a plan to expand the Dutch coast. Integral coast and delta policy via building with nature.
In these densely populated areas, there's only little space available for living, working, tourism, recreation, and infrastructure. And at the same time, there's the need to preserve or expand valuable environment, nature, and landscape. For the scarcity of space, there are three solutions. One is using more than before the third dimension, using height and depth and multifunctional use of the existing space. A second solution is looking at possibilities in the existing hinterland. And a third solution is in the direction of the sea. By introducing the principle of building with nature, no longer dominant dams and dikes as bulwarks against the sea, but instead introducing dunes and beaches in harmony with the sea, we have the possibility of a whole series of functions in the new land. And at the same time, we increase the safety for the existing hinterland. Everything in harmony with nature.
Building with nature makes far greater use than before of inorganic and organic materials present in nature and the forces and interactions acting on them. Inorganic materials include sand, from fine to coarse, silt, clay, and gravel. The organic materials are the flora and fauna abundant on land and in the sea. More precisely, landside vegetation, varying from marram grass to mangrove, and marine organisms, varying from micro and macro algae and seagrass to mollusks and worms. The forces and interactions are wave and tidal movements, gravity, wind, ocean currents other than tides, river discharges, rain, sun, dune vegetation interaction, and complex interaction between marine organisms and sand or silt. Another vital aspect is coastal type and the genesis of the coast and seabed, the biogeomorphology and geohydrology of coast and seabed. This strategy says no to building more dams and dikes as dominant bulwarks against the sea, and yes to dunes and beaches in harmony with the sea. The strategy is more energy efficient and good for nature and the environment. The strategy also aims to achieve a new, flexible, dynamic, balanced coastline consisting of dunes and beaches with a minimum of hard sea defense elements. A coastline where growth and erosion exist in equilibrium, minimally maintained by periodical sand suppletion, thereby integrating land in sea, but also integrating water in the new land, in the form of lagoons, lakes, harbor basins, and fresh water lenses under the dunes. Such an approach, based on building with nature, integrates land in sea and water in the new land. Building with nature is inextricably linked with integral coast and delta policy. Integral coast and delta policy answers the question, how can we solve a series of existing and future problems in relation to each other and in relation to the existing hinterland on the one hand and the adjacent sea on the other, while creating added value? The solution is found by taking many functions and hence many disciplines into consideration, from coastal defenses to environment, nature, and landscape, from water resource management to energy, from building locations for living and working to infrastructure and recreation, from participative stakeholders to social health and welfare, and everything in between. Waterman's plan aims at a series of sustainable, multifunctional land reclamations along the Dutch coast, all based on the principle of building with nature. Thousands of hectares of new land, as well as new sea reserves, have already been realized this way. All the reclamations optimize the available space, but also boost the economy, guarantee safety, and improve the living environment. For instance, in the mid-1980s, the Slufter Dam was created in a two-step process, complete with dune and beach boundaries. This was followed by Maasvlakte 2, with a similar dune and beach boundary extending 7.5 kilometers along the west flank. The area covers a total of 2,800 hectares of new land, including harbor basins. This new, unique part of the Netherlands creates port and port-related activities for the municipality of Rotterdam, complete with multimodal connections with the hinterland. The 7.5 kilometer dune and beach boundary on the west side of Maasvlakte 2 provides safety and recreational use. Adjacent to it, on the southern side, a new terrestrial nature reserve for flora and fauna, and again safety, has been created on land belonging to the municipality of West Vorna. This landside nature reserve borders on the evolving Slufter, a seascape acting as a mating and breeding ground for marine organisms and the birds that feed on them. This Slufter is part of an assigned total of 25,000 hectares of sea reserve. The largest plan aims to restore the approximate historic coastline of the early 17th century between Scheveningen and Hoek of Holland. The coast that existed then has been lost due to rising sea levels, storm floods, the changing course of rivers, and land subsidence. The aim is a step-by-step restoration of the coast with a new hollow coastline, complete with ports, infrastructure, living space, and facilities for recreation, in combination with large nature reserves. As a first step, the Van Dixhorn Triangle at Hoek of Holland originated in the 1970s when Maasvlakte 1 was created. The Hoek of Holland site on the North Sea, at the outflow of two major European rivers, the Rhine and the Maas, with the Rotterdam agglomeration in the hinterland, is unique. It justifies further expansion with a tidal lagoon, complete with a multifunctional marina, homes and facilities, multimodal infrastructure, and a substantial nature reserve on the northern side. A hotel conference center with a high-quality revolving restaurant offers a panorama view of this unique area. An expansion of the dunes and beach on the Delftland coast between Hoek of Holland and Scheveningen creates extra safety as well as space for recreation, infrastructure, and nature development. Between 2008 and 2012, along a 17-kilometer stretch between Hoek of Holland and Scheveningen, the dunes on the seaside were expanded with the new beachfront. This involved the creation of Spanjaard's dune at Schravenzande as nature compensation for Maasvlakte 2. In the next 20 years, this area will become a larger dune area, rich in moist dune valleys. A new cycle path overlooking dune, beach and sea has been built between Kijkduin and Hoek of Holland at the transition between old and new dunes. In Scheveningen, the realization of the De Sola Morales plan, with an attractive boulevard connected to a beach expansion and elevation, has resulted in a generous coastal zone with a hollow coastline. In the protected axil of the extended northern harbor mole, there is space for a line of dunes, which protect the beach sports stadium behind it and its corresponding facilities. Further plans for Scheveningen involve the creation of a fourth Scheveningen port to the south of the extended southern harbor mole, including a marina. If desired, a cruise terminal and nature zone connecting with West Dune Park and a new south-oriented beach can also be created. The new water defenses at Katwijk integrate a garage and dike construction, protecting the vulnerable center with dunes. The development of a marina with broader dunes on both sides and space for a portage or sluice connects the old Rhine with the sea. The resulting development offers an attractive place to live and will boost the local economy. Adjacent to the marina, the existing dune natural reserve area between Katwijk and Noordwijk will be significantly extended towards the North Sea. Between September 2007 and April 2008, the coast of Noordwijk was already reinforced by a dike in dune construction. The dunes were made 42 meters wider with a new beach in front of them. The new dunes are the same height as the current ones. The projected dune beach extension between Katwijk and Noordwijk will result in a new hollow coastline between Katwijk and IJmuiden. The IJmuiden Seaport Marina, south of the extended southern harbor mole, is a coastal location with a marina, nautical center, apartments, shops, restaurants, a hotel, parking facilities and public transportation amenities, as well as Kennemer Lake and the adjoining nature reserve. The inner side of the southern harbor mole has a third port outside the sluices of IJmuiden with port-related activities and a so-called perched beach with two rows of beach huts. The existing solid Honsbosse and Petemer sea barrier is reinforced through building with nature. This is realized by a dune beach expansion in front of this sea barrier with an overall span of 11 kilometers. This expansion has a width of 200 meters at a central stretch of 7 kilometers with a tapering off on two sides of 2 kilometers each. This solution combines safety, nature development, and recreation.
Further successful implementation of building with nature relies on good coordination between governments, knowledge institutes, education centers, and on the corporate sector, with emphasis on environment, nature, landscape, and on the social sphere. We are now poised to take advantage of unprecedented opportunities for future sustainable spatial developments through building with nature.
The principles set out in Building with Nature and Integral Multifunctional Coast and Delta Policy can also be applied to areas other than coastal zones. Perfect analogies exist between living coasts, space for the coast, living rivers, space for the river, and living deltas, space for the delta. The principles maintained can be applied not only to the Netherlands, but also to other regions in the world with vulnerable, densely populated coastal and delta zones. The flexible integration of land in water and water in the new and old land offers countless possibilities, all based on building with nature.